Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Please subscribe my channel if you do not want to miss a single lecture of this series. Today we will discuss about the transmission electron microscopy or TEM. I hope you went through the last video of my microscopy lecture series, that is the overview of microscopy. If not, please have a look on it. I am providing the link in the description box. So in our last lecture, we have already talked that electron microscopy is beneficial for higher magnification and greater resolution. Transmission electron microscope offers valuable information about the inert structure of sample. Now we will talk how does TEM work. So, first component of electron microscope is an electron gun. It produces electron beam. Electron gun itself is a cathode, that is negatively charged cathode. Second structure or second component is anode. As electrons are negatively charged, they are accelerated toward the anode. Third component is a condenser. Like light microscope, its work is to focus, and it focuses the electron beam onto the object. So, sample is now focused by the electron beam. Next is the objective lens. It is used to focus and magnify the image. Last is the imaging system. It converts the electron image into the some form that is perceptible to the human eye. Finally, image is digitally captured for display on a computer monitor. One important stuff is there to mention. TEM is bathed with multiple electromagnetic lenses. Unlike the lenses used in light microscopy, these are not glass lenses. These are electromagnetic lenses. Since electrons are charged particles, electromagnets are used to focus them. Now we must know how does the image form in TEM, or you can say how contrast is formed. Now contrast between two adjacent areas in an image can be formed due to the difference in the electron densities. During the interaction of electron beam with the sample, some of the electrons will be lost due to absorption. The darker areas of the image represent those areas of the sample where more electrons are absorbed and fewer electrons are transmitted through, while the lighter areas of the image represent those areas of the sample where less electrons are absorbed and more electrons are transmitted through. One important thing to remember is in TEM, samples and electron beams should be placed in vacuum. Without a vacuum, electrons being aimed at the sample would be deflected when they hit air particles, and specimens should be very thin and dehydrated. Some advantages of TEM are: it has very powerful magnification, it has high quality and resolution, it provides information on compound structure. Some disadvantages of TEM are: it is very large and very much expensive. Laborious sample preparation. operation and analysis requires special training. Images are black and white. They cannot display living specimens in natural colors. It requires special maintenance. So that's all about TEL. Hope you understood the concept. If you liked my lesson, please do like, comment and share my video. Thank you.